UNIS is part of the growing numbers of hurting people that are coming to New Life Evangelistic Center at this time. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. UNIS is part of the growing numbers of hurting and homeless people who are coming to New Life Evangelistic Center at this time. There are so many people in need, so many hurting people. And UNIS, you are in your electric wheelchair or scooter. You're in your scooter.
Yes.
And you came to New Life. Why did you come at this time?
Because I knew that I could get assistance on my utility bill to keep it from being cut off. I'm so thankful for New Life being given extended time to be open. And it's even going to be even more extended time. Man says one thing and God says another. And I just thank you for being able to help others with care packages, bus tickets to get back and forth to work, the vegetables and fruit that you have here for the people to come and get. It's just a blessing that you all are here and to help the homeless to not be on the street.
Well, Eunice, we need everybody praying for us because in September the 22nd,
yes, sir,
it's going to be a major federal trial.
Okay.
Over whether or not the city can dictate to a church like New Life Evangelistic Center, mm-hmm, how many people can be in their congregation, mm-hmm, and how many they can service, okay?
Right.
And is government going to totally control the church where it's told you can't have 300 members, mm-hmm, you can only have 32. And that's what they're, so that's why we need people praying for us at this particular time. This big federal trial coming up in September, and we need people also getting involved in the Greater St. Louis Homeless Jesus Fund that you can find more information about by calling 881-3218, 314-881-3218, or going to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. But Eunice, you're here, and I understand that your Social Security is being cut, and you're just about to have your lights shut off?
Yes, that is so true. For medical insurance, I have to pay it now out of my pocket. Mm. They're paying a portion. I've got to pay the other portion. So
I'm going to be back talking to Eunice further, but first I'd like to go to Solomon, who works with Dave in our life skills classes, where she mentioned bus tickets earlier. Those receiving such come to life skills classes where they learn budgeting and how to apply for job, how to use the tickets to break the cycle of homelessness. So let's go to Solomon.
Hi, I'm Solomon Brooks with New Life Evangelistic Center here. I'm standing here with Brenda Spates. We've just had our life skills class, and we have it Tuesdays and Thursdays at 10 o'clock a.m. Brenda, let us know what conditions you were facing to lead you here at New Life Evangelistic Center for Transportation Assistance.
To be truthful, to get to these appointments that I'm trying to get, mm-hmm, before the end of this month, which is already the end of this month, I'm trying to move into my new appointment.
Mm-hmm.
And no disrespect, but I got an appointment with the Veteran Affairs right at this present moment.
So you're a veteran?
Yes, I am.
What branch?
Army.
Army. Oh, okay. Yes, that's great. You see,
that nice?
Yeah, that's great. You see here, we have a veteran standing here, and she needs transportation assistance. All right, Brenda, just let us know how you're going to use these four bus tickets to your advantage.
From the case to buy steak to the Veteran Affairs and to the Housing Authority.
Okay, let us know how God has blessed you.
For waking me up and forgetting me as far as I am. I'm 63 years old. Thank God.
All right, there you have it.
Thank you much. Have a blessed day.
I'm back with Eunice. And Eunice, you were telling me a little bit earlier about how they've been cutting your Social Security. Why are you in the scooter?
Because I have multiple disabilities. I'm a fall risk. I had a tumor on my spine in 1986. And when it was removed, it left me with bile tract, urinary tract, and nervous system damage. And I can only go a certain length, a certain distance, and I'm no good. Steps, I'm no good at. You know, it's just, it's a lifesaver. I wasn't born on this now, but it helps me along during the day.
What would happen if your lights were shut off? What would happen to you? What difficulties would that create? How could you charge your scooter?
I wouldn't be able to charge it. So thankful that you're going to help me today. It's a blessing.
And again, I don't know if people realize, New Life Evangelistic Center, unlike other major organizations, receives no city, state, or federal dollars. Who doesn't? And because it does not take the city, state, or federal dollars, it is independent to continue to help those in need in spite of how the city wants to control homeless shelters. New Life is the largest major independent shelter that gives them the right to continue to remain open all night long when the city has shoved them out of their neighborhoods and said they can't be open all night long. It's New Life Evangelistic Center they come to because we believe this is what Jesus wants to do all night long. Women, used women, little children, veterans, we're open. We're the emergency room for the homeless. City don't want that. They want them out of sight and out of mind. They want, they want everybody to think that the mayor's taking care of the problem. They want people to believe their political propaganda. The New Life Evangelistic Center believes the scripture and is trying to help them. And it's been trusting Jesus for 43 years. We've seen how God has graciously and miraculously provided through caring people like you. We take 10% of all of the gifts that we receive. It goes in our mission fund, needy fund, so we can help this lady and others. And I'm asking you to just continue to pray for New Life Evangelistic Center and share your much-needed gift now. It's a faith organization that believes that Jesus Christ is alive, and he says, call upon him in the day of trouble. He will hear, and he will deliver us. And I just want to say this real quick as you're praying. Don't go directly to the supplication or the request aspect. I have found these four steps of prayer to be so essential. When you're praying, spell out the word acts. Okay. The first thing you do is you engage in adoration. That's worship, praising God. And as you do that, you start to see that God is bigger than that problem. You go straight to supplication. You start feeling overwhelmed by the problem, and you start engaging in vocalized worry. But engage in adoration first. Adore him, okay? Amen. And as you do that, like Isaiah, you may finally find yourself before the altar, and you'll say, Lord, heal me of my unclean lips. I've confessed my sins. The C, after you spell out the A, the C is confession. You ask God to forgive you for your sins. And then the T is actually thanksgiving, where you're able to start thanking him. Lord, I know you got everything all under control. I know you're going to meet this problem. I believe in you, Lord. What it does, it has your mind to be awakened that God is bigger than every problem. Then you go to the S, the supplication. Okay. So you spell out the word acts. A-C-T-S. Yes. Adoration, confession, thanksgiving, and then supplication. Okay?
Thank you.
And then watch the power unfold. Watch the power unfold. Watch him do exceedingly beyond what you can even ask or think as he delivers you from your worry. Because what you've done when you engage in adoration and thanksgiving, your prayers have been upward bound. All right, upward bound. Then when you engage in the confession, they're inward bound. Yes. And then when you engage in the supplication, they're outward bound, okay? So there you are. It's a well-rounded prayer focus that you can get directly involved in and watch God do exceedingly beyond what you can even ask a thing. And as you're engaging your acts of prayer, follow it with acts of compassion. And please remember the New Life Evangelistic Center in your prayers. And that kind of praying does two things for you. One, it builds your relationship with God. And number two, it helps get the needs met. So let's go to God and let's continue to pray. Yes, please continue to remember New Life Evangelistic Center in your prayers as we go back to Solomon.
Today we're here at the Tuesday's Life Skill class. This is where people see transportation assistance. They get a hand up and not a hand out. Many people are become financially unable to afford to go to work, to make interviews, and to get their apartments, their prescription assistance. But what we do here at New Life Evangelistic Center, we offer people these services so they can get a hand up and not a hand out. And here I'm speaking with
Ashley Phillips.
Ashley, tell us what you learned in this life skills class today.
I've learned to cut back unnecessary things to meet the criteria to have a good budget so I can afford transportation and get to the places that I need to be.
Let us know what circumstances you were facing that led you to come here to New Life Evangelistic Center and receive transportation assistance.
Well, I moved into a couple of low-budget apartments that were shut down, and I am struggling trying to survive through nursing school.
Let us know how you're going to utilize these four bus tickets to your advantage.
Well, I'm going to utilize those four bus tickets to get back and forth to work.
How has God blessed you through this ministry since you've been coming and receiving services here?
Oh, okay. The Lord Jesus Christ, he's my Savior. He keeps me faithful and keep my head above water.
Okay, and there you have it.
I'm back with Michelle at this particular time. And Michelle, we've been just talking about the power of prayer, okay?
Yeah.
And do you pray?
Yes, I pray every morning, every night.
Good. And we were just talking about, Michelle, when we pray, instead of just engaging in a vocalized worry thing, God, help me. I can't pay my bill. Lord, help me. First, engage in adoration. We start just worshiping God. As you do that, the blinders fall from your eye and you see that God is bigger than every problem, okay?
Yeah.
And we spell out the word acts. And then from there, we move into the C for confession, thanksgiving, and then finally the S for supplication. We ask you to pray for these needs also that we bring before you. Tell us about your need.
My need, I'm actually here for some utility assistance.
What happened?
Well, I lost my position at my job, which dropped me down to 2 days a week, mm-hmm. so it kind of put me in a financial situation. I reached out for some help, and I was referred here.
And other agencies referred you here?
Yes, it was.
And the only way we're able to meet these needs is through the power of God, working through caring people like you, because we're not dependent on federal government funds that are controlled by the city's continuum of care, the mayor's office. We go directly to the Father. And as the Holy Spirit speaks to caring people like you, we're able to help so many people in need, giving people a second chance. People have literally nowhere else to go, nowhere else to turn. Turning to New Life Evangelistic Center in growing numbers. We're working to be there when people are hurting. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. And giving online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Opportunities available to you. Let's go back to Solomon.
We're standing here at the Transportation Assistance class, the Life Skills class that we have Tuesdays and Thursdays at 10 a.m. in New Life Evangelistic Center. I'm standing here with Destiny and her son, Zayon. Destiny, tell us a little bit about yourself and why you're here at New Life Evangelistic Center for Transportation Assistance.
Hi, I'm here because I was living with a life struggle. I had a spouse that we disagreed on our relationship, and I didn't have nowhere else to go, so I came to New Life Christian, and they was a very helpful. They helped me get back and forth to find housing, find work, employment, and help me find a new appointment.
Okay, Destiny, let us know how God has blessed you through this ministry.
God has been also, he with me, and he been blessing me, getting me up and taking care of my son, and he been blessing me, taking care of my son, and giving me the strength to wake up and take care of my business and get back and forth to find housing and unemployment.
Let us know how you're going to use these four bus tickets to your advantage so that you can receive resources to not only help yourself but also care for your son, Zayon.
I'm going to use these to go to the Housing Authority and apply for Section 8 and go to my school for disability to get my records and to find a daycare for my son.
All right, Destiny, there you have it, and she's going to receive four bus tickets. Here you go, Destiny. All right, now God bless you.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm back with Michelle. Michelle, had you tried a lot of places for help?
Yeah, I had tried quite a few. Some said they didn't have any funds. Some told me to try back later. But when I tried her, they gave me an appointment date. I came down, and I was able to get help.
Answer to your prayers?
Yes, I seek the light.
Oh, God is good, isn't he? He loves
all
you.
All the time.
He loves you. And in the middle of your need, he's right there, okay?
Yeah.
Just continue to pray. And as you're praying, as I mentioned, spell out the word acts. The A for adoration. Start worshiping God. As you do that, the blinders will fall from your eyes. And because if you just focus on the problem and say, help me, help me, help me, Jesus, pretty soon the problem gets bigger than God. That only makes things worse, okay? So we've got to start with adoration. As we do that, we start to see what a holy God we're worshiping. And the only way we can come into his presence is through the resurrected Christ. And so we engage in confession, thanksgiving, and supplication. Let's go back at this particular time to Solomon.
We just completed the life skills class today. It was taught by me 10 o'clock this morning. We have our life skill classes 10 o'clock Tuesdays and Thursdays. Sign up is on Monday and Friday at 10 o'clock a.m. We're servicing transportation assistance. You can receive four bus tickets. We want to give you a hand up and not a handout. We serve the St. Louis community here in homelessness. We serve people as far as prescription assistance. But we're right here now talking to Paula Gooden. Paula Gooden, let us know how this ministry has helped you.
I've come a long way in this ministry. In the last 4 years, I was homeless, living on the streets for 2 years. I've come a long way. Now I'm a heart patient, and I need the transportation for heart to go into my doctors and job search.
Let us know what conditions you were facing and what circumstances led you here at the New Life Evangelistic Center to receive transportation assistance.
After struggling on the street for a while, losing my job and losing my apartment, and New Life has come a long way. It's helped me and guided me in the direction.
What has God done for you? How has He blessed you through this ministry?
God is still working with me. I've come a long way.
All right, Paula, I'm glad to give you your 4 bus tickets here. All righty. God bless you now.
So far up to this time, I've been personally talking to the women, and now I got a man with me, and people see a man and they say, why does that man need help?
Well, I'm a single person. I'm on a fixed income. I don't get a whole lot of money, and I think this program is just set up for people that's not less fortunate. I think it's real good. I think this is a blessing to people that's less fortunate and don't have a lot of money to support themselves and their bills.
You hear an awful lot in the media, and it often seems like there's this great gap between where the police officers are and where the African-American man is, right?
Mm-hmm.
What are some of the struggles of the African-American man? Help people to understand.
Well, to me, I think from the very beginning, just being a person of color, mm-hmm. You're already a statistic anyway, because from the beginning, from when I was born up until now, realizing certain things going on in the world, you know, I try to steer away from it, but it's hard for me to just sit back and look and not be able to do anything. I feel kind of helpless.
Well, at the same time, that's why you might have to just work a little harder, like all of us do when we try to take a stand and people speak bad of us, okay? To know that we're made in the image of God.
Yes.
And regardless of what they might say about us or what they might try to do to us, greater is He who's in us, Jesus Christ, than he that's in the world, right?
Yes, sir.
And we're just going to have to work a little harder to engage in those acts of prayer, to knowing that God is bigger than every problem, that He loves us. We've been made in His image. He made us this way.
Yeah, He did.
And confess to Him whenever we let bitterness overcome. I have to do that. Just say, Lord, help me to love you, Jesus, right?
Yes, sir.
And bless those who despitefully use me and persecute me.
Yeah, that's right.
And then thank Him in all things and all things. Just say, Lord, I'm just thanking you that you're going to let something good come out of all this. Teach me, Lord, how to make lemonade out of those lemons.
And He does.
Amen. And then we get to the S of the supplication. God is a great God.
Yes, He is.
He's a great God. And He loves you, brother.
Yeah, He does.
He loves you. And I know you're trying, so we're going to try to help you. At the same time, we're asking you to help us as we desire to reach out to all people, recognizing each and every one's been created in the image of God.
Yes.
God bless you. And keep
Thank
the faith
you.
Now, okay?
Thank you for all your help.
Well, Lord bless you. And you keep praying for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center as we're working to be there when people are hurting.
Hi, I'm Erica Pothig, Institute Fellow and Director of Urban Policy Initiatives at the Urban Institute. Rental housing assistance is often mistaken as an entitlement, but in reality, it's not. Unlike Social Security, Medicare, or food stamps, housing assistance does not serve everyone who's eligible. Only 1 in 4 who are eligible actually get assistance. Those who don't stay on a long waiting list, often for years. So who gets it? Eligibility is based on citizenship, gross income, and family size. In general, the people who get rental assistance are determined by a lottery. As a result, more than 5 million households, including 4 million children, get rental assistance through federal programs. Elderly and disabled make up more than half of this number. Why do so many people need housing assistance? Of all monthly expenses families face, such as food, transportation, childcare, and healthcare, the rent check is typically the biggest. And households spending more than 30% of their monthly income on rent are what economists call housing burdened, meaning home expenses crowd out other spending, including food and healthcare. It's estimated that 8.5 million renter households currently pay more than 50% of their incomes on rent, live in substandard housing, or both. Americans who are not housing burdened have the opportunity to invest their income in real wealth-building tools, such as education, healthcare, a down payment on a house, and savings for retirement. We're seeing that a chain of benefits snowballs for those who spend 30% or less on housing. Unfortunately, the number of Americans who pay more is growing. As the cost of rent goes up and the incomes of renters go down, more people live in housing they cannot afford. It is a common myth that a majority of those receiving assistance are simply gaming the system. But when housing burdens are alleviated, a whole chain of benefits occurs. On a family level, children have more stable lives. For the elderly, they live healthier and longer. For the homeless, more find safety in a home. The reality is the need for assistance is growing in America, and our current policy is not doing enough to alleviate housing burdens in cities, suburbs, or rural communities. To really get at the problem, we need to invest more in rental assistance at the local, state, and federal levels.
Robert worked his whole life, and now he gets his retirement income. He's trying to live on it. How much is that a month, Robert?
$667.
And how much is your housing cost?
$550.
That don't leave you much, does it, for the gas bill, the light bill, the water bill, and the rest?
Right. And plus, got to have something to eat.
Your food stamps don't cover it all.
I don't get food stamps.
You don't get food stamps.
Because I had a criminal history once.
So then they just cut it off.
Cut it off.
But he's a child of God. Man of God. And you know, it'd be easy to, in the latter part of life, to get so depressed, get bitter rather than better because of all the hurt and pain we've seen over the years.
There's a lot of hurt and pain, especially I'm a veteran.
Uh-huh.
And I haven't started receiving any help from the military yet, but to keep me holding on, maybe before I leave the world, maybe I get some help from the military.
When were you in the armed services?
In 1968 to 1974.
Where were you?
I was in Vietnam, I was in Germany, I was in Korea.
Did you see action?
Action in Vietnam. The rest is just tools.
Yeah. Here he is, another veteran. So many veterans falling through the cracks, but the last place they have to come to is the New Life Evangelistic Center. That's why we need your prayers, brothers and sisters. That's why we need your support. That's why we're the last major walk-in shelter in mid-America and one of the last major outreaches among the homeless that are independent from the government control, the federal funds they give, filtered through a city that engages in gentrification, the destruction of affordable housing, making it harder and harder to actually get to a lottery system so the people can actually get a place to stay, and move it to a point that things have become so difficult and desperate for hurting people at this time. We got to hang on. How does your faith help you keep hanging on?
I got faith in the Lord.
How does that keep you going?
Keep me going strong.
What would you do if you didn't have that faith?
Probably walk out in the middle of 70.
Walk out and then do what?
Walk out in the middle of 70.
Oh, like suicide.
Right.
Your brothers and sisters, this is the salt in the city. Faith. Faith that keeps people going day by day by day. I've been sharing with folks up to this time, I want to pass it on to you, the importance of taking that faith now and implementing it in our prayer.
Right.
Okay. And when we're praying, we want to spell out the word acts.
Right.
The A for adoration, where we just adore and worship God.
Right.
It brings us to the point we see we're in the midst of a holy God made possible through Jesus Christ. Our sin, we can confess.
When right.
Call upon the name of the Lord, shall be called the children of God. Then we can engage in thanksgiving. Lord, you have not forgotten me yet.
Yeah.
I've been made in your image, Lord God. You love me, Lord. And in spite of the discrimination that's going on, and in spite of the difficulty to get any kind of basic housing, and in spite of the lack of resources, you're my provider, and you're always faithful. You've been taking care of me all these 66 years. You're going to keep taking
yes, sir.
Care of me. Amen.
Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
66, right, are you?
Yes, sir.
All right. And then the supplication. At that point, we say, Lord, as we see him established in our mind, heart, and being fully God in control of all, Lord, now I bring this request, and I lay it down before you. Lord, I thank you, Lord. You know the nice thing about being 60s, you can look back over the years and see God's been faithful, brought you through all that stuff.
Yes,
Vietnam,
sir.
Probably the time they're shooting at you.
Yes,
you
sir.
Say, God, help me, get me out of this.
Get me out of this.
Well, here you are.
Yeah, I'm out.
Amen. Now the devil of the world and the flesh may be shooting at us, but God is there. We got to keep trusting him. And yes, the housing situation is getting so difficult. It's the rest of the story. Those local municipalities don't want to tell you about the gentrification, where they get the rich and wealthy, all kinds of tax abatements, tax incentives, stealing the property of the poor, the needy, crushing them, destroying their home, and now trying to destroy the last major walk-in shelter in mid-America, a church that they want us to take the 300 members we'll have up to a night. They're not really members. They're people, anybody and everybody that's in need, down to 32. And it's the last major walk-in shelter. All these shelters the mayor talks about and the other papers just run with it because they're right there with him. The head of Human Services used to be an editor over at the St. Louis Post, so don't be surprised. The Post lines up with the mayor all the time and publishes all their stuff. Well, the fact is for the rest of the story, stay tuned right here. And brothers and sisters, we're here to tell you not only about the city, but St. Louis County, 90 municipalities, not one single walk-in shelter. St. Charles, not single one single walk-in shelter. Jefferson County, not a single one there, are over in Illinois. We're desiring to continue to be there when people are hurting. I'm asking you right now, in the name of Jesus, to get involved in the Greater St. Louis Homeless Jesus Project. For further information, call 314-881-3218. And let the light and love of Jesus flow in you and through you. And you keep the faith, brother.
I got to keep the faith.
You keep praying for us.
I'm praying.
We're going to try to help you here.
This shelter open. They're trying to, it's the snakes are after us.
Yeah, the devil's mad because people are getting saved, people getting delivered as they stay here, as they live here. Wants to try to crush the place that's offering people hope, but we can't let it be crushed. We got to stand steadfast.
Right.
God is in control.
Yeah.
He's in control, and we need you to stand with us. We need you to pray for us. We need you to share that much-needed tax-deductible gift. It's no accident you tuned in. New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166. You can give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. I thank God for your involvement. And brother, you keep on praying now.
I am.
You keep on praying. Believe in God. How did you end up coming to New Life Evangelistic Center?
I have been in four in the program.
Uh-huh.
And last time I heard you, when we used to have on Friday,
uh-huh,
you used to tell everybody, say, after 30 days up, if you got any kind of money, go and find you somewhere to live.
Uh-huh.
So I took your advice. I went and found me somewhere to live.
And you got a place now, right. And you're just trying to keep your electricity
right
on there.
Yeah.
But during the time you stayed here, it was a big help to you?
Yes, sir. Very big help.
Well, that's what we do. Give him a hand up, not a hand out. This is a hand up to a brother that's taken that hand up, got his own place. Now he just needs a hand up to keep the lights on. And we want to continue to do that through the grace and power of our Lord Jesus Christ. I thank God for each one of you that are getting directly involved. It's getting hard out there as far as affordable housing is concerned. It's getting hard. We got to keep on trusting God, keep doing His work.
Hear this, you who trample the needy and do away with the poor of the land. Let justice roll on like a river, righteousness like a never-failing stream. You trample on the poor and force him to give you grain. Therefore, though you have built stone mansions, you will not live in them. Though you have planted lush vineyards, you will not drink their wine. For I know how many are your offenses and how great your sins. You oppress the righteous and take bribes, and you deprive the poor of justice in the courts. Seek good, not evil, that you may live. Then the Lord God Almighty will be with you, just as you say He is. Hate evil, love good.
Do you hear the Word of God? Do you believe the Word of God? Then will you fight to continue to let the Word of God move forth through the work of New Life Evangelistic Center? Yasmin is joining me. She was abandoned in the city of St. Louis. Where would you have slept last night with your in your handicapped situation? You used two canes if it had not been for this place.
I don't really know where I would have slept last night, to be honest with you.
Quite a shock to you, isn't it?
It was.
To have something you never
scary.
Thought this would happen to you.
No, I did not.
Never.
No, I didn't.
Abandoned in the city of St. Louis.
Yes, sir.
But you were an answer to her prayers. All of you that are praying for New Life Evangelistic Center, all of you that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center, when all the other places were full and closed, there was one place still open, a place that insists on following our Lord Jesus Christ and the mandates of Scripture and not that of City Hall and other governments that continue to take people's homes through gentrification and then try to stop the last major walk-in shelter in mid-America. That's why we're going to federal court in September. That's why I'm asking you to pray for us. No government should tell a church they have to go from 300 members to 32 just because they consider them a nuisance and they don't want the poor people in their neighborhood. Please pray. These are perilous times, godless times. But the people of God are arising. They are praying and they are sharing. Will you join them? It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. You can get further information by going online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org.